They are commonly used semiconductor material that is developed to be semiconductor device. So, pwede siya mahimong silicon, pwede semiconductor diode ng germanium, and pwede siya gas. So, the most commonly used semiconductor diode is the silicon, since abundant to siya, dagan siya tagag stock. So abundant siyang element. So unlike the germanium and the gallium arsenide, so limited ang GE as well as the gas, but the silicon more abundant compared aning duha. So that's why silicon is commonly used as semiconductor diode. So let's discuss the forward bias current, the ID, no? In a forward bias current, diba, if the diode is on, naka-on siya, naay current flow. So that current flow is considered as the I sub D. Muna niya ang one current ID, forward bias current. So in order to calculate the forward bias current, you will use this formula. ID is equal to I sub S times e to the power of V sub D divided by N times V sub T minus 1. So just refer to the book, chapter 1. Naroon siya sa chapter 1. Chapter 1, so I think parihara tag page. Nasa sa page, I think... page kuan 12, page 12, another dapat chapter 1 page 13 or 12, where I sub S is the reverse saturation current. Well, so sa reverse saturation current, so for example in a diode, so muna yung diode, no, at forward bias, no, PN. So if naka forward bias ya, meaning naka on siya, no, na yung current flow ID. So in reverse saturation current, ang nahitabo is ano, no, PN. So if naka-reverse ta, so in this case dapat ideally no current flow, but since this is actual na siya, naamgid na siya, mulusot gamay nga current, so that is considered as the reverse saturation current. Usually ang iyang magnitude ani sa saturation current is mostly na sa microampere. So microampere is na siya sa 1 times 10 to the negative 6 ampere. So micro. Sa forward bias current, nasa sa mga yung magnitude, nasa milliamps. No, milliampere is nasa 1 times 10 to the negative 3 amps. So if you compare these two, so usually the reverse saturation current is very very small compared sa diode forward bias current. Let's continue. VD is the forward bias voltage, no? Ideally, so ang ideal VD, it should be equal to 0. So dapat walay voltage drop ang atong diode, but in reality na siya ay voltage drop, magdepende sa ito ang semiconductor ng diode. So voltage drop for silicon is na siya sa 0.7, VD sa germanium is 0.3, ang kaning gaas is na siya sa 1.2 volts yang voltage drop, no? So the smaller the magnitude of a voltage drop of a diode, mas better. So ang smaller ani is 0.3, no, 0.3 germanium. But as you can see, what I've said earlier, the most abundant is the silicon. So, wala pag mas dako si silicon, abundant man siya. And then, dagan mo siya advantage compare aning duha. So, that's why consider nila ni. The larger, ang largest nila is the gas gallium arsenide, which is 1.2 volts. Ang N is the ideality factor. Well, usually, kasagira, ano, we'll just use N equal to 1 in this textbook. So, sa VT, V sub T, that is equal to the thermal voltage, where V sub T is equal to K times T sub K divided by, where K is Boltzmann constant, 1.38 times 10 to the negative 23 joules Kelvin. TK, absolute temperature, it should be in Kelvin. So, the formula sa Kelvin, so Kelvin is equal to degree Celsius plus 273, no? Where Q is the magnitude of electronic charge, 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 coulombs. Coulombs na siya. So, in the forward bias current, if you plot this one, kaninga formula, yung muna i-graph, ang result niya is kani. Muna ang yung plot. Ayan o. So, maka kita ala ka sa libro ano eh. Nalagay po niya sa chapter 1. Or sa canvas, nasa canvas. Dito na ito sa canvas. So, sa canvas, this is the actual diode characteristics. So, as you can see, this is current versus voltage. Current VID versus voltage VD. So, at zero, no? With no bias, zero po niyang response. So, as you increase the voltage further, so in this case, this is silicon. Silicon na itong gamit. Pag abot niya 0.7, ay ha, siya niyang saka. So, ni-increase yung current. So, at this state, ning on lang ito ang diode. But for germanium, kamay-gamay siya, no? Ito siya, 0.3. So, GE. Samot na sa gas. This is 1.2. So, you start to increase the voltage. Buo na rin yung diode. So, if mo na siya, na siya ay current flow. But at the reverse saturation current, so, for example, at reverse bias configuration, diba, if you increase the voltage, negative naman yun, if you increase the voltage, na siya ay gamay kayo nga, saturation current, microampere. As you say, microampere nga. But as you can see, na consider niyo mga plot, if you increase the voltage further, no, maabot siya siya ang breakdown. Tawag na itong breakdown. Breakdown siya. Breakdown. Well, kaninga point, we call this voltage. Kaninga point, this is the breakdown voltage. No? So, ang tawag ani is the Zener region. So, breakdown voltage is the voltage where the semiconductor diode is na-reach na niya yung breakdown point. Or, we call this one the avalanche breakdown. Kaninga region is Zener region. Kaninga point is called the avalanche breakdown. So, as you can see, maabot siya nga point. So, if you increase the voltage further, maabot siya nga point nga mo. Moon na siya, no? Mundako na yung reverse saturation current. Where in this point, guba na yung mong diode. Guba na siya. So, wala na yung dapat on og off man siya. Forward on, reverse off. Yeah. So, The breakdown voltage can be determined if mutan ako ka sa data sheet sa semiconductor diode. No, later on i-discuss nato ng data sheet. So let's have an example. At ang temperature of 27 degrees, common temperature for components and enclosed operating system. Usually, ang mga electronic devices is load ng aircon. So that's why 27 degrees. And usually, po, kaninga book, nani siya sa mga bugnong lugar, cold places. So that's why gagmay ni. So kung sa ato apa ni, 32 degrees. But, igamit man na kaninga book, so that's why we'll use 27 degrees Celsius. Determine the thermal voltage V sub T. So, gamito na ito ang yung formula. Ayan o. So, where VT is equal to K times TK divided by Q. So, K is equal to, this is the Boltzmann's constant, which is 1.38 times 10 to the negative 23 joules Kelvin. Times, as you can see, this is 27 degrees Celsius man, so this is 27 degrees plus 273. So divided by, ang charge na to is 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 coulombs. So 1.38 times 10 joules Kelvin. Ilan mo ni? This is 300 divided by 1.6. So therefore, calculo BT na to is equal to 25.875 millivolts, or approximately equal to 26. So millivolts siya. So it's very important to write the unit. Kung wala unit, wrong. So 25.875 millivolts, or approximately equal to 26 millivolts.